Hi guys, welcome back to our channel. I'm Maya.
And I'm Dr. Riz.
And today we're going to show you how to grow microgreens in both soil and in water, which is hydroponic. So these are the microgreens. This is what we're going to teach you how to grow. Welcome back to our channel, where we have been teaching you how to grow your own food using a simple deep water culture system, which is part of a hydroponic system. And we have various videos that we've already put out. If you have not seen them, I'll put them either in the cards or in the description box below.
And now we are going to start experimenting a little bit with microgreens. We have been eating microgreens more and more this year. That was the next project I wanted to do. So Maya actually got a microgreens growing kit.
Eat Your Greens Organic Farm has a starter kit in case you're interested in growing it on your own. Organic soil. You'll have the seeds.
That one's in soil and I want to use hydroponics. So we're going to compare soil versus hydroponics in growing microgreens today.
Okay, and to start off, I'm going to show you what microgreens look like. And Dr. Riz and I eat the greens in sandwiches. We put them on salads and soups and things like that. And you can also put them in your smoothie. Mm-hmm. And this is what the greens look like.
So it's a mix of various greens.
Yes,
and
it is.
And it's a spicy mix because I think it has wasabi in it or maybe arugula.
In my review video, you'll see that I have plastic containers and those are basically samples that they provide when you're first trying out and trying to figure out the mix you like. So this one's called the Spicy Super Mix and it's a blend. It has broccoli, clover, arugula, wasabi, and radish. So let's give this one a taste. Okay. What I taste the most is the arugula. And in this household, we are big fans of arugula. We decided we like the spicy superfood.
Yeah,
we got. You like them a lot in your sandwiches.
I do. We got to try several different kinds. And then when we decided that we would order from them, I asked Maya to get me the spicy superfood mix because I enjoyed the variety. I like the taste of it.
So these are the microgreens. This is what we're going to teach you how to grow. And we have the kit from Eat Your Greens Organic Farm. So should we get started with that one?
Yep.
Okay. This is what the kit looks like. And you can order it online from them, from Eat Your Greens Organic Farm. And I'll put the link again. So when you first order, you get to choose what seeds you want. And this is what you pick up. And you'll have instructions. You'll have your soil. You'll have your seeds.
So there's two trays in here. One tray, it has some slots in it, and this is the tray which the soil goes in, and that's so that the water drains out. The other tray does not have any slots in it, and we'll show you how that's used. And the seeds are right here. These are broccoli seeds that they provide. So they provide everything you need. They even provided the spray bottle.
The spray bottle. While Dr. Riz explains a few more things, I'm going to put on my gloves. Don't want to mess up my nails right now.
So we're going to start by putting the soil in the tray. The soil, as I already mentioned, goes into the tray with the drainage holes that are already pre-cut. So we'll start with that. Here you go.
And do I put all those soil in here?
This kit comes with everything that we need for growing one set.
All right. So
get the soil in there. Push it down and tamp it down pretty even.
Okay. So I'm going to do this. It says to pack it down. So I'm packing it down and I'm making sure that I cover the edges. Or go, you know, along the edges as well. But you don't want to pack it too tight.
Yeah, just tamp it down. If it's too tight, then I think the seedlings would have a hard time putting roots in.
Okay.
So you're going to spray it fairly thoroughly, with about 3 or 4 ounces.
There we go. Well, we got that area real good already. Do these microgreens have to be under LED like the system we have back here?
So no, you don't. I mean, I think that people you can grow microgreens on next to your window or outside in the patio if you wanted. Mm-hmm. Under natural light. We were planning on using our LED lights because I have those grow lights that I've been using for my hydroponic garden.
How's that?
I would keep going. I can take over for you for a minute. We're almost done. Gosh, can you imagine that? So the next thing is to evenly spread the 14 grams seeds that they've provided for you.
Broccoli microgreens are some of the nutrient-packed greens that are out there. Okay, so would I go like this maybe?
Yeah, just spread it evenly throughout the whole area. That's the right amount of seeds for it. Some people soak their seeds ahead of time for a few hours, anywhere from 4 to 8 hours depending on the seeds. And in this particular case, we decided not to because we saw a lot of people's recommendations. When you soak these seeds ahead of time, then it actually becomes harder to disperse them evenly throughout the bed here. The advantage of soaking them is that they might sprout a little bit faster, and then spray the seeds to get them wet on top.
Oh, right. The seeds will lie on top of the soil.
Mm-hmm.
How long does it take for these to mature to the level that we want to consume them?
It's a little bit different everywhere you read. Some say 8 to 12, some say 10 to 14. I think that's pretty generous.
I feel like I concentrated one area right here. I guess we'll see.
We'll find out, yeah.
Okay.
And then place the tray without the holes on top inside the cedar tray. So now you're going to switch the trays.
Okay.
And basically now what we're going to do is we're going to allow these seeds to germinate in the dark. So we cover them up. They apparently like a little bit of pressure, not too much. It's almost like they're being buried in the soil.
So these are going to have to be in the dark for how long?
So now we put them in the dark for 3 to 4 days.
Wow, this is so cool. All right, so now I'm done with the soil system. Now Dr. Riz is gonna go on and he's gonna start his hydroponic system.
Yeah, so we're gonna put this in.
I'll put it back here for now.
And then we'll put it in a dark closet for 3 to 4 days.
Okay.
So you don't need your gloves anymore.
Oh yeah, I don't. I'm so used to wearing gloves right now because of the pandemic, so.
And she took those off very well. I taught her how to take off gloves medically, inside out. I've become fascinated by the whole topic of everything hydroponic. So when she was going to do her seeds in soil, I said, well, I want to do some too, and I want to do them hydroponically. I bought some seeds, and I bought what we call a jute mat, jute, J-U-T-E. And jute is a plant, and from that plant you can get fiber. And one of the things they do is they make mats out of it that you can use for microgreen harvesting or growing. I got mine off of Amazon, but it's the company's name, Greenies, and they have a website with other products and resources. I'm in no way affiliated with them. I looked up jute because I had no idea what it was, and it is the second most common threaded fabric behind cotton in the world.
Wow. Yeah. Is it like burlap?
I wonder, hey, is burlap made out of jute? These are 10 by 20, and I bought a tray, or actually already had a tray, which is 10 by 20, so I'm going to be doing this in a 10 by 20 tray. But what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to cut this in half, because I'm going to do half spicy microgreen mix, and I'm going to do half broccoli, like to match what she's doing. Now, so there's my growth medium. It's the jute mats inside my tray. So no soil. And now the next thing I need to do is almost identical, is I need to get it wet and then just let it soak and then pour off the excess water. I'm kind of getting the impression that the best thing to do would be to completely soak this in water for a few minutes before you actually plan to put your seeds on there. That way the mats can absorb the water.
That makes sense.
So now that I got these wet, I'm actually gonna go pour off this excess water. So I have my wet growth medium now, and super spicy greens, which is a mix of arugula, cress, radish, turnip, and mustard greens, which I'm gonna put on half. And then I got broccoli for sprouting and microgreens, which I'm gonna put on half. So in looking about the density on, Maya's came pre-measured, and it said 14 grams, which is about 3 teaspoons for the 10 by 10. So I'm gonna do exactly hers, which is what she did, which is 3. So this is the spicy microgreens. A bit more here because I got some empty spots. All right, so I'm gonna do 4. So there's my spicy microgreens. And now the broccoli. Okay, so now I've sprinkled my seeds, and I have my own little spray bottle here to get my seeds wet. So we put them in a dark area, but we don't want it to be too hot in there because we don't want these seeds or the mats to dry out. So I think they say the ideal temperature is anywhere from about 60 to 75 degrees. And not too much heat or not too much running air where you might dry these things out. And then I have another tray which I'm going to use to put on top, both to put a little bit of pressure and to block out all the light. And then the next thing we'll do is, I guess we'll put them on the back over here and then cover them up just to make sure, ensure no light gets on them.
All right, so I'm back.
So that's it. Now we have started the growing process. We get to do nothing for the next 3 to 4 days. I was thinking during this, why do you worry about whether it's in soil or something else, right? And what's the differences, or are there advantages and disadvantages? From what I've read, the nutrition value isn't any different, okay? Because the nutrition comes from the microgreens themselves. Some people have said there's an advantage to the growth mats because you don't have to worry about having to deal with soil. So it's a much cleaner process. And sometimes there's some people say that as the microgreens grow up, some of the soil gets into the microgreens, so you have to worry about cleaning your microgreens when you harvest them. Maybe, and it might be a little harder to harvest from soil than from a mat.
Right.
Yeah. And that'll be something that will be coming up in the next few days as we grow these things.
Yes. Well, guys, we hope that you enjoy this video. And if you did, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe. And also let us know what you think about growing microgreens. In part two, we will actually show you all the stages that the microgreens went through. We will discuss which was better, using water or soil, and a few of the lessons that we learned. And again, thanks a lot for watching.
Don't forget to subscribe.
Hit that notification button.